Wendy, I'm home.
The first movie that comes to mind is probably The Shining. I just think Stanley Kubrick's a genius, and this movie in particular, seeing an auteur who's not a horror movie director per se bring his unique vision and craft to this movie is really exciting to me.
That was one of those things out there, trying to imitate him, Gary.
Another film would be The Thing. The way it's set up, there's not even like a clear hero. I didn't know who I could trust, and it terrified me. But what terrified me more was the people and what this monster that could shapeshift and take different forms did to the people and the paranoia it instilled in them.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
Another horror film would be Night of the Living Dead, George Romero, the first zombie film. It's primarily this one house with these zombies outside of the house, but I personally don't think it's as much about the zombies as what the zombies force the people inside to confront and the shift in the power dynamics. And the end puts everything into perspective and makes it a movie of its time and really has a message and something on its mind.
What is it, Mr. Baxter? What is it you feel?
Talking about endings, you don't look now. It blew me away, like chills down my spine. And it hit me not just scared though, like it hit me emotionally, like I cared about this man and everything it led to. But it wasn't just a horror movie, and I don't even know if I consider It Comes at Night just a horror movie. I think it's a lot of different things. And I always love the idea of combining a horror movie or elements from these movies that I love with a family drama.